Lee Sin for sure. It's his best historical champion. Also think there's a good reason to have a Sejuani for team comp reasons, but this is more about trying to keep up
with that bubble to find kind of
a
play.
Big fight.
Definitely could be. The recalls are already in. Jensen pushed back. 1500 health on this Drake. It's now hitting Groxus, switching back over. Spite Fight gonna come in pretty soon, maybe. Johnson is slowed. TP's coming in. They found the root, though. Bullet time over the top, and a first kill comes in to fight in as well. Look at the fight for Dignitas. 2-0. The dark of the back line is very big, but coordinated drops as well. Finally, a kill on the board for Set, and it splashes out for Dignitas. Nice knock of in for Greg. Jensen finds one. Flash to safety. Now, Afmu's in danger. Has to put up the shield, but Double is so easily gonna kill his ex lane mate. There's no way out for that one. And his team Liquid now picking up three kills on the back. Nicely done by them. Chase down. Froggen. Wow, not the best record. But a lot of time in bad teams. Now the team fight comes in again. Great rumble. Afmu very, very low. Flash to safety. Here comes Panther over the top. Gets some backline access. Double if does go down. But already a double kill for Jensen. The chase down. Frigg is gonna drop. And Team Liquid.
Can stuff happen?
Impact. Full HP under a turret.
Really
on
hard
a set.
To dive a set.
Well, he's gonna try though. Q, auto, auto. Knock up. Not gonna find one for Greg. But here comes four members as Varus pushes in the wave. Afro can pull back whoever pulls aggro first.
He's got W and R.
He's smart about turret aggro. They warm up the turret for him. He ults in the back line, gets a bit of safety. Greg cannot get eaten. He's going after Sonya's that one. Hoodie's gonna go down as well. Dignitas botch the dive horribly. As now Afro is forced to run away, but he's slowed a little bit. Will Impact find the rest they need? Shield comes in. Afro has the gray health. Goes for the stun, big damage coming in. When will he pull this? Has to do it now, might be on cooldown. Here comes the second Q, goes in for the punch! And Afro won't quite die, he stopwatches. There's no skill shots left available, but Dignitas just joined the squad. But Dignitas is still pushing, you don't always get to see the second turret attempt. And this is gonna be maybe a decent dive. Q's gonna land, pulled back in. Huni's gonna feel fairly safe. Jumped up to drop turret aggro, and with the new wave, they will get a second turret. So positive stuff for Dignitas, gets two turrets on the board.
Yeah, first turret bonus, and this means an Ocean Drake goes over to Team Liquid. So nice, but still a lot of catching up to do for Dig as baby.
Damage.
Yeah, true.
I feel like I see your point. I'm going to pause it. This ends up not quite.
Panth is definitely better than both.
Okay, that's good. All right, well, I'll take it back for now. Nice one!
Woo! There's the Broxa Lee Sin. That's Sejuani can't do that.
No, she can't. That was awesome. Broxa single-handedly takes down a champion. That's going to be mid lane crack wide open for TL.
He also had the Rift Herald, right? So he did the control ward jump.
Yeah.
Then he had to place this. And they're taking two.
They're getting two for sure. And ooh, they almost found the barrier in the way. Jensen can't get in range. There is Infernal grabbed up. 10 minutes. Mark your calendars. 19 into the game.
Let's dig, try, and engage. We're probably not seeing. Yeah, it's definitely Ghost.
Seems likely.
TL trying to get that vision, and this could be the fight.
Huni wanted to fight. He finds Core JJ, gets a stun, gets some damage. Ult comes off, shield comes down as well. Bullet time pushes back Johnson, and his double two supports hit support.
Boy.
There's the slam. Huni stop watching by a couple of seconds, but Impact is there. Move over!
Kick.
And the kick as well. Might find some more kills. Johnson's dead now as well. It's a 2-0. Make it a third, a double kill. Four double lift as now Grig is running away. And you know what? It took about 2 minutes.
Thresholds. Jensen zoning out Grig now as the rest of the team take Baron.
I mean, they focused the stone plate drop. Of all partners to pick, it is, I think, literally the worst possible one. Nice pickup for Jensen. Now, I will say that Team Liquid did leave the Gitas jungle. They pushed out of the jungle and said, hey, go.
Very potent Zoe game.
Yeah.
Interesting here how they are pushed top. I'm not getting a huge amount of damage down.
They've done the half HP. TL definitely playing it very slowly, very pokey here. They do miss three flashes on the squad. Only Jensen and Core can get away from a hard engage. That is what Dignitas wants to do here. And Core takes some damage, but he's still going to stay reasonably safe. Grig at half health, though, just tanks the Battlestar.
Yeah, it looks like they just want to break this turret and then maybe turn for Inferno.
It's definitely gone. That was going to knock down. Inhibitor was going to be pretty much a freebie then at that point. Team Liquid still staying to knock down some minions. Huni gets some damage on Impact, but again, that set is very tanky and walks away safely. Mid and Higgins is cracked.
Team can take a 9,000 gold lead or a Baron to end, but as long as they're stacking up towards an eventual Dragon Soul, and when you look at these next one or not, They might be ulting in here. Hooney's thinking about it. They're going.
That is in the bottom lane. This is now the go moment. Can it work? Now for Dignitas. The Cataclysm in the back line. Big damage over the top. Jensen jumps out. It's a one kill, but now traded back. Hooney's going to be dropping probably as well, as Dignitas now only have 3 versus 4. Kiting away as best they can. Getting a bit of damage down on the table. Aphromu would need a miracle to steal. I don't think it's going to happen. Q's going to land. Get away from now. Baron goes over yet again. Well, if Tom catches this, maybe not, but now Grig has to walk backwards as mid is under fire, or sorry, top is under fire as well as that turret is cracked. Top and Hib's gonna fall here as well. The Baron buff in full use, and we're only 30 minutes into the game, and TL basically has ended it already.
And I think we're gonna see a final fight here, because they're gonna try and roach it over to some third and Hib where they don't have minions. The only way Dick can stop them is by actually fighting, and Hooney's sitting on the fountain, so watch for that Pantheon ultimate. We might see the final fight.
They know it's flashless MF, flashless Zoe. It's gotta be the target. Grig, marked by impact. Here comes Pantheon. Decent damage. Who can they find? There's a stun on the one, but he gets right away, and he's gonna stay alive. They're still gonna go for it. They can. Impact could be a big threat and get some damage across. Grig forced out, never even able to ulti, and Hooney now drops as well. Good peel for Team Liquid. They win the fight, they'll claim the bottom inhibitor, and they'll reclaim mid.
Core JJ peeled double if well, but Impact actually won that fight. He held off the entire Dignitas backline. Has set Steric Gage, Gargoyle Stoneplate, just bought the maximum amount of time as the third inhibitor is broken, and this could be the final push as the super minions stack up.
They find the potential sleep. Will there be follow through? Tompkins denies that one, but the turret is gone, and only one is left. 5v4, Grick tries yet again for ult and EQ. Abraxa finds that kill, his first of the game, and now the fight continues. 5 versus 3. Turrets are gone. The flash in for Core JJ wants to have another kill. There's the pullback for Impact, and he's got himself yet another kill. They're 5-0-7 on the set. As now Dignitas are forced to run. The victor will be asleep, takes a big chunk of damage. The Nexus falls, and Team Liquid improves to 4 wins.
And there's a big sigh of relief. Interesting debate. I think it's going to be the Sej, because it does give them a very, very strong front line. Although, it's like, to your point,
though, to stack the tier defensively, does need combat stats to battle the shoving. Really big damage. Broken Blade! The straight!
It's about how quickly can Dardock make something happen with this Rift Blade top. They're actually teleporting and going for a lot. They want the turret.
He's going for a heavy play. Nice ult to bring Kumo to safety. Broken Blade now in turret range. Flash for the W, but he can't get the damage. That's an easy chase down. That is first turret going to drop in the top side, and a second kill for TSM.
Yep, they're going to do the... There's the Herald, okay.
Yeah, yeah.
I was going to say they're going to do the 2.5 plates and then let the Herald charge, and Dardock had already been channeling it, so there's first turret. And Bjergsen has pushed mid lane, so that's probably because Jizuke felt trapped with the flank coming in behind him. TSM finishes this turret as well to extend their
lead. Thus, on Trisk, don't bother buying attacks.
Okay, and TSM's pushing the mid lane with Cloud up. EG's not really getting anything here. They're not getting river control or mid control. Normally, if a team pushes mid, you're at least setting up Fission around Drake, but TSM is actually controlling everything.
Cool. A little bit of poke. TSM feeling very comfortable getting kind of everything they want. They have yet to clear up a Drake themselves.
Good control wards there by EG, though, if they're looking to find a fight. You got to lead with ult.
Oh, it lands for the slow. It's still damage. Is there a play to be had? Terrible comes down, and TSM going to feel fairly safe, but they have
to hear actually how... I think TSM could have still tried to fight here. It would have been a low percentage. You kind of have to just get the Drake. But they're unable to do so with the enough poke coming in from EG.
Ult attacks too.
Oh, there's some Ornn fighting going down bottom. I just saw the ult go off.
Kubo's knocked up yet again, then slammed back down by the pillar, and suddenly Kabe is there. A dunk for the back line. Kubo has to run. The flash follow means a knockup. They find the slow as well. And next bell basically kills. Kabe's almost going to be with Rocket Jump up in a second. There's the auto, there's the kill. Kabe is on a...
And it's a kill for a turret. Now would be the window to drop.
4v5 until Kumo respawns. Mid-tier 2 definitely drops, and TSM able to walk away and take a wolf game.
I mean, they saw Jizuke in the side lane, so TSM knows that they can't actually get outnumbered in that play. Jizuke's still pushing the side lane, actually, so all outers are now dead. And there's no
one on the map. Actually goes for the Black Cleaver upgrade onto Dardock first. Baron, as it's the next major objective. 26 minutes in, very large gold lead by the top side.
Play.
Oh, wow! Jizuke made it not.
It goes round and round, and sometimes you get the big play.
It's back to tails.
But it's a trade.
Jizuke is like definitely dead here. That's a slow, that is a knockout.
Try something.
He's gonna go right into Kabe's face.
Yeah, but, you know. They got a turn off it too, probably.
Okay.
They got multiples. They got the set turn and the Braum turn.
You know what? This time Jizuka is recalling. Broken Blade just charges forward to make them disengage and cracks the inhibitor. Now the play is towards Sejuani. Svenskar gonna kite backwards. Bjergsen has burned the ult.
Oh, they didn't block the ult.
Or goes in for a little bit of damage. And it's his hit towards Kumo as well, who stays alive on top. Jizuka wants Secret Redemption. Is gonna undo that damage. TSM feeling comfortable, ready to crack the mid inhibitor, and they will indeed do so.
Aaron can steal.
Jizuka burns W, might go in for R in a second, kites back, 2.5k, this is the moment, and it's picked up by Darduk, a good spike comes in, kicked back, looking at the re-engage, already a 1-0, Kumo is alive, puts the W, but no one will die, TSM claim a 3-0.
This could be the game, they have the inhibitor broken in the mid lane, and top and bot waves are actually already pushing with minions, so they're going for at least three inhibs. It took a while, Freak, but it looks like TSM might have just broken it open.
This is going to look really nice for them as they already pushed down. And look at that one. That is a very dead inhibitor. Looking now at the first of the turrets. 15 seconds on most of the important respawns. Jizuka chunked out with just an auto attack. This turret's at half HP. That turret's gone. Second turret's going down as well. How do you stop the bank? Can't possibly have the damage. Push down to the Nexus. Quick CC comes in, here's the respawns. They're gonna try their hardest, but the Nexus will fall, and TSM gets sole control of third place.
Their third 2-0 week.
Bud Light breakdown because still soup in the middle, and I do that just to piss off Mark, but it's also a stretch from the bottom towards the top if you are Team Liquid 4-6.
I mean, just with that single win and EG's loss, there's now a four-way tie at six when just earlier today was a sole possession of ninth place. So I think Team Liquid's going to be pretty happy with how things actually look at the end of this week, considering how dire it looked after their loss to EG yesterday.
I mean, actually, wasn't the soup like the second through fifth place teams? Now it's like the sixth through ninth.
It was the second through ninth for a little bit. It was just CLG and C9 not in soup.
So now is this technically cool or is it hotter now that it's?
I think the metaphor is dead. I regret bringing ever saying that.
Yeah. I'm really happy Mark hates the soup comments because now everyone loves it.
Well, we'll shift it from 1S in soup to schedule in a whole different direction. We already prefaced that TSM and Team Liquid will be facing one another for the second game of the day on Saturday. But is there any particular match that either of you are drawn to?
FlyQuest C9.
Yeah.
Best two teams in the league right now going to play out. I hope to finally see C9 get challenged. Even if FlyQuest can't win, can they last longer than like 35 minutes? That's like honestly what I'm
looking
for. That's
the win condition. Or not win condition, but success condition.
Yeah, that's what feels good to me as a team playing C9 is like we didn't get absolutely train wrecked.
I think you're the only person that will feel good about that. No one else in the world is going to be like, wow, 35 minutes and lost after 35, great.
At that point, it would be abnormal to last that long against C9.
It's fair. It's a weird, like, happiness, but
I mean, if you can win, great.
Yeah, there you go.
I just don't think it's going to happen, so.
There's a certain accolade, though, that many C9 members have received. And before we hand it off over to the Bud Light League Lounge, we have to give a congratulations to our Massacre Player of the Week this week, which is FlyQuest Power of Evil, bringing that much more spice to their matchup that will be kicking off next Saturday.
Yeah, no surprise. Great Orianna game. And then more impressively was the Corki game that came after this. Absolutely dominating. Had 32,000 damage over the course of the game.
Yeah, both those clips are really fun because you normally don't see Orianna getting solo kills because mm-hmm. she's such a very, you know exactly what she's gonna do. She's not too flashy of a champion. So calculating damage is not too hard. And then in that last clip, you see Corki actually engaging a fight. And that's also, technically Ignar.
Technically Ignar, yeah.
Initiated it, but you saw the Corki go in, fly across the team fight. And that's a really